Good morning, my dear children. Today we are going to start chapter 2 of SST, that is Forest of India. We know forest as our forest wealth, a natural resource. Forest or the trees gives us life. No life on earth can survive without forest, that we know. Okay? And we know that it's a very, very important natural resource, and every country must or should have at least 1/3 of their land area as forest. But unfortunately, in India, 1/5 of the land area is covered with forest. That means it should be 1/3, but actually it is 1/5 of the land area. And children, if we talk about the importance of forest, why do we need forest? You must have studied about food chain in science. Everything depends on the other person, and every living thing other than trees or plants depends on the forest only. Forest depends on us, and we depend on forest. If we at the upper level, at the top layer, if we see that forest gives us wood, they give us medicine, spices, they give us hardwood and the softwood, and after that they clean our air, various kinds of animals and birds, they live in the forest, they get their shelter in the forest, we get many kinds of fruits, many kinds of herbs, rubber we get from the forest. That means so many things we get from the forest. So forest is a very, very important and natural resource. Even forest check the global warming also. Soil erosion is prevented through forest. Floods are prevented through forests. They are the reason to bring the rainfall. They form the clouds, attract the clouds, and they leave lot of water into the atmosphere, which is very, very important for the continuous and the regular rains on the earth. And they protect the soil also. Okay, otherwise our land will be converted into desert area. So many importances are of the forest. Now, if we see, I have prepared here notes. You can see here few things I have written here. Now from here we shift to the types of forest, our main topic of this chapter. How many kinds of forest we are having? We are having 5 kinds of forest: evergreen forest, deciduous forest, thorn forest, tidal forest, and mountain forest. Now we will study in detail about each and every kind of forest. First of all, let's talk about evergreen forest. Children, here you can see the picture of the evergreen forest, a kind of picture that I have taken from the net. You can see here that we can only see the greenery. Evergreen forests are also known as tropical forest. As you can see here, that I have written here tropical forest, other name of the evergreen forest. Now, in which region evergreen forests are found? Children, they are found in the hot and wet regions. We know that what we need for a plant to grow, we need water, air, and warmth. And the areas which are hot and wet, that means the areas are hot means warmth is there, wet means water is there and air is already there. So the weather there or the climate of these areas is exactly suitable for the plant life to grow in abundance. That is why these in these regions means in Western Ghats, in Andaman and Nicobar Islands, the climate is hot and wet. And hills of the northeastern part, that means if it northeast part, which If we move beyond Bihar, it's the eastern part, and north means Jammu and Kashmir area, and upper portion of the Punjab, upper portion of the UP. So there we find evergreen forest. Now few of the examples for the trees which are found in such forest: mahogany, rosewood, ebony, climbers. Few climbers are there. Many varieties of bamboos are there. Large varieties of ferns are found here in evergreen forest. Now here comes the question: why we call them evergreen forest? Children, see here. We call them evergreen forest because they remain green throughout the year because they do not shed their leaves at one time. Children, we know that as winter approaches, or every plant or every tree, especially trees, they used to shed their leaves during the weather which is not suitable for their growth, so that they can protect themselves and they can survive that weather. But what is the special feature for the evergreen forest? That the trees, so many trees are there, and maximum trees are not shedding their leaves at one time. Different trees are shedding the leaves at different times of the year. So every time we feel them as the tree, this forest is always green. That is why we call it as evergreen forest. Now why it happens, why so many number of trees are there? Because the weather is very hot and humid, and such kind of weather is suitable for the too much growth or the thick growth of the vegetation. Vegetation means many kinds of trees. Now children, what kind of animals are found in these forests? I have taken few names, otherwise abundance of animals are found there, like monkeys, bats, crocodile, panthers, lions, tigers, many kinds of birds are there, reptiles are there, lizards are there, so many kind of animals are found there. So this was all about the evergreen forest. Next special feature of the evergreen forest is that the trees are very large because weather is highly suitable for their growth. So trees are very large. You can see here the length of the tree, you can see here. And children, you can see that at the top, these, they are forming a canopy. Canopy means an umbrella like structure. Evergreen forest trees are so tall and thick, vegetation is so thick, that sunlight cannot penetrate through these forests on the ground, on the earth. So many times if we go deep inside these forests, it's totally dark because sunlight is not able to penetrate through the thick canopy which is formed by the long trees at the top. It's an umbrella like structure. You can see here, it's a like umbrella like structure, like we cover ourselves with umbrella over the head during rains or during the sun. So this is the special features of the evergreen trees. Different kinds of trees which are available in deciduous forest. Now we see the special features of the deciduous forest. First of all, as these regions, which are the regions? Again, see the Indian northeast part of the Indian Peninsula, and we are having the foothills of the Himalayas. As these regions are not, means they are not having much rains. So what happens? Trees growth, the growth of the trees is not like as the trees of the evergreen forest. Okay, and they shed their leaves also at one time, so they never fear. We cannot say that the trees remain green every time. Okay, and winters, because they shed their leaves during the end of the summer and winters, mostly the trees are without leaves so that they can survive the harsh weather, harsh cold climate. And after that, trees shed their leaves also so that they can save water through transpiration. Because children, I hope that you know what is transpiration. Transpiration is the loss of water from the surface of the leaves. But when leaves shed their leaves, then transpiration is protected, and the plant get the water, whichever water is available in the ground, for their growth. what kind of animal life is there. Tigers, lions, deer, pigs and various kinds of birds and snakes are available there. Now these are the deciduous forests. Now children, we shift to the next kind of forest, that is thorn forest. Thorn forest means a forest or the trees of this particular forest with thorns on them. Now children, just little bit shift towards your science. Which trees are having thorns? Thorns are the trees which are available in the desert area. And what are the desert area? Desert area is the area where very little rainfall is there. That means the area with very less rainfall. So water is not available for the trees to grow. So these kind of forests are not having very long trees or very thick trees. Rather, they are having trees which can survive very less water. And these trees are having very long roots so that they can penetrate deep into the soil in search of water. These trees are having very thick bark, again to save the water, whatever water is available. Then these trees are having very sharp thorns, and these thorns actually are modified leaves. Leaves modified into the thorns so that transpiration, that means loss of water, can be avoided through the surface of leaf. And plant can survive, or that particular thorny tree can survive with the less amount of water. Examples of the trees which are found in the thorn forest: babool, kikar and white palms. And where these trees are found? These trees are found in the desert region. Rajasthan is a desert area in India. Then in Punjab we are having desert areas, and in Haryana also we are having desert area. So such kind of trees are found in the desert area. And children, this pic I have taken, it's a Nagfani plant. Here you can see, this is the green part, is the not the leaf, it is the stem and spines. If you can feel, the spines are there. These are the modified leaves are these. Next, we shift to the next. Now next we shift to the tidal forest. Children, tidal word means the high tides and low tides which we feel or experience in the sea area. Whenever you go to visit a beach, you will experience their tides. Okay, so tidal forest means the trees which are found on the delta region of the rivers or the sea. Delta region means the area which is formed by the sand and silt brought by the river, and that sand and silt is deposited at one particular place. So a delta is formed. The region is very fertile, and these trees, because they grow on the site of the water, that means these trees are having the special features that they can survive both in fresh and salty water, because sea water is always salty. The other name of tidal forest is the mangrove forest. We call tidal forest as mangrove forest also. And these trees, they grow in the areas which are submerged in seawater. That means the land is covered with the water. Everywhere there is water, and below the water is the land. These trees grow in that region. So where are they found? Ganga and Brahmaputra delta regions, these trees are found. Which trees, children? Tidal trees. Sundari tree is an example of such kind of tree which grow in mangrove forest. And a Sundarban is a tidal forest which is formed because of the Sundari trees. Sundari tree. So this Sundarban forest is named after Sundari tree. Okay, tidal forest. Now here you can see the picture of this tidal forest. See, you can see here the trees are there and water is there. The trees are growing on the side of the water. And second picture is of the Sundarban trees, mainly Sundari trees. Because of Sundari trees, this particular forest has been named as the Sundarbans. So now we shift to the next kind of forest, that is the mountain forest. Children, as the name indicates, these mountain forests are found in the mountain region of, we are talking about India, so mountain region of India, and the mountain region is the Himalayan region or the Nilgiri Hills. These forests, mountain forests, are found in the Himalayan region or the parts of Nilgiri Hills. Now children, you can see in the picture that trees are very long, tall, and if you can feel, I won't say the picture is very clear, but the leaves are in the form of means their leaves are long and in the form of a pointed needle. If you can say, the leaves are in this shape, pointed needles. Why? Because in these regions, sorry, this picture is, I'm not able to draw it properly. This picture, these are in the form of pointed needles. Why pointed needles like this? Why pointed needles? Because in this region, rains are not there, rather snowfall is there. So when snow falls on a leaf which is in the form of a needle, snow does not get chance or area to remain on that leaf. So for the protection of the leaf, the needle shape does not give chance to snow to settle down on it, and the snow will fall down and leaf will not spoil due to the chilly snow. Okay, and second thing is here, the needle shape of the leaf protects transpiration also, and these trees can survive in the snowfall, that means the zero, the temperature which is below 0 degree. And the trees are coniferous tree. Coniferous trees means in the form of cones, they bear the cone which is their fruit. Examples of the trees are cedar, pine, fir, chestnut and deodar. These are the examples of the kind of trees which are found in the mountain forest or in the Himalayan region. So children, this was all about kinds of forest and what is forest, why do we need forest. This was all about that. Now I am going to end my video, and in the next video I will take up the topic of how can we save trees and how can we save animals which are found in different forests. Okay, till then, Mita, thank you. Bye.